This is Apollo Control at 150 hours, 4 minutes. Telemetry data at this time shows the spacecraft in the proper attitude for the upcoming mid-course correction maneuver. The crew will soon be verifying their attitude by taking a sighting on a star through the sextant and then be running some tests on the guidance and control system and the reaction control system before the maneuver takes place. That burn now scheduled to come in a little over 25 minutes. Apollo 11 is now 170,102 nautical miles from the Earth, and the spacecraft velocity is 4,058 feet per second.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. We'd like you to try acquisition on the high gain antenna for us at pitch minus 90, yaw 270, over.
Roger, that's the work.
Roger out. This is Houston. We're showing about 6.8% on wastewater on our telemetry now. Over.
Okay, got about 9 up here. Over.
Roger out. 11 Houston, we're standing by for your burn. Everything's looking good from down here.
Thank you, Bruce. You got about a minute and 20 seconds.
Roger, we can curve.
One minute now until mid-course correction number 5. That will be a 10.9-second burn of the spacecraft reaction control system thrusters, giving a change of velocity retrograde of 4.8 feet per second. The primary purpose of this maneuver will be to control the spacecraft flight path angle at entry interface. We're now less than 30 seconds from the initiation of the burn. They should be burning at this time. And we show the burn off.
Houston, you copy our residuals?
Roger, we've got your residuals. Do you have a counter reading for us?
Delta BC is plus 0.2.
Roger, plus 0.2.
Yeah, it was actually plus 100.2, okay.
Okay.
That mid-course correction was performed at a distance of about 169,000 nautical miles from the Earth. The spacecraft velocity 4,075.6 feet per second. This is Apollo Control at 150 hours, 35 minutes. Our telemetry data here on the ground shows that mid-course correction maneuver just about nominal, burn duration 10.5 seconds. Prior to the maneuver, we were predicting a splashdown time of 195 hours, 17 minutes, 25 seconds. We expect there will be some modification to that after we've had a chance to do some tracking following this mid-course correction maneuver. Apollo 11 is now 168,843 nautical miles from the Earth, traveling at a speed of 4,078 feet per second. And we're continuing to see a very slow buildup in the velocity.
Houston, Apollo 11.
Go ahead, 11.
Roger, we're NPTC attitude, and would you please give us a call when our thruster activity has subsided sufficiently?
Roger, stand by.
Thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. We're going to hand over from Madrid to Goldstone at 151 hours even. If you should lose lock on the high gain at this time, you may reacquire at pitch minus 45, yaw 270. Break, we're still watching your race, over.
Okay, thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
11, we're still seeing rates on your spacecraft above those that we'd like for in a continuation of the PTC mode. We're still monitoring it, and we'll advise you when it's settled down, over.
Okay.
This is Apollo Control at 151 hours, 11 minutes. The crew is presently setting up the spacecraft for passive thermal control. Once it stabilizes out, they'll begin a slow roll rate of 3 revolutions per hour to maintain temperature control. At the present time, Apollo 11 is 167,448 nautical miles from the Earth, and the velocity is 4,101 feet per second. Thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Your go for the spin up on PTC, over.
Thank you.
Apollo 11, over.
Yes, sir. Go ahead, 11.
Right, it didn't like it that time. When I got down to the entry 27303, enter, it took off and roll at a high rate in excess of 1 degree per second, over. So I've stopped it now, and we're going to have to go back and do it over again. I'd like to try to find out the reason why it did that.
Well, Roger, you might as well start setting up for it, and we'll be working the problem here.
Okay, did you have us on high bit rate here, Ned?
That's affirmative.
Okay, good. I'll maneuver back to PTC initiation attitude while you guys look at the data and see what you think.
Roger. Apollo 11, this is Houston. While you're waiting for the CSN to settle down and for us to look at the tapes on your latest maneuver, would you feel like answering some more questions with relation to the lunar surface? Over.
Go ahead, Bruce.
Roger, for $64,000, we're still trying to work out the location of your landing site, Tranquility Base. We think it is located on LAM-2 chart at Juliet decimal 5 and 7.8. Do you still have those charts on board? Over.
Yeah, stand by when they're back.
Roger, you may not have to unpack it. The position which I just gave you is slightly west of West Crater. I guess it's about 0.2 kilometers west of it. And we were wondering if Neil or Buzz had observed any additional landmarks during descent, lunar stay, or ascent which would confirm or disprove this. One thing that we were wondering about is that if you were at this position, you would have seen the cat's paw during ascent just up to the north of your track. Over.
We were looking for the cat's paw too, thinking we were probably downrange beyond the Big Z. But I think that it's likely that that might have been West Crater that we went across in landing, but stand by. We're hoping, Bruce, that our 16mm film was working at that point in descent, and we'll be able to confirm our touchdown position. We thought that during ascent we might be able to pick up some recognizable objects close to the landing site, and we did see a number of small craters and crater rows and things like that, which we may be able to pick out after the fact, but we haven't been able to yet.
Oh, Roger, and the next question from our panelist for Buzz. We recall that he reported seeing a laser upon AOS of the Earth the first time after, the first rev after ascent, and we're wondering what color the beam was and if he could determine its approximate location with respect to the Earth. Over.
It was mostly white, perhaps a tinge of yellowish color to it. And it seems to be, as I recall it, the terminator of the Earth was toward the horizon. And seemed to be about a quarter to a third of the way down from down toward the terminator of the Earth from the opposite horizon. That's a third to a quarter Earth radii. Over.
Roger, and that puts it in the light side. Over.
Roger, yes, it was in the light side. The Earth was about a two-thirds lit Earth with the terminator down toward the horizon. And now coming from the opposite limb of the Earth, the sunlit limb, coming down about one quarter to one third of a radius in from the limb. Generally centrally located with respect to a line drawn perpendicular to the terminator that goes through the center. Over.
Roger, Buzz. We copy.
And I got pictures of that. I'm sure that'll show up.
And I saw that too. It was a very bright spot of light, and I confirmed Buzz's observation of its position.
Okay, 11. Very good. Now, with respect to the documented sample container, on television it appeared to us as though the samples for that container were in fact being being selected in accordance with some thought or consideration being given to the rocks themselves. And we were wondering if you could give any further details from memory about any of these samples and the context of the material or the surface from which they were taken, or?
Yes, if you remember, I initially started on the cut side of the limb that the TV camera was on, and I took a number of samples of rocks on the surface and several that were just subsurface. About 20, 15 to 20 feet north of the limb. And then I recalled that that area had been probably swept pretty well by the exhaust of the descent engine. So I crossed over to the southern side of the limb and took a number of samples from the area around the elongate double crater that we commented on and several beyond that, and tried to take as many different types of rock types as I could see by eye as I could in the short time we had available. There were a number of other samples that I had seen earlier in our stroll around the lab that I had hoped to get back and pick up and put in the documented sample, but I didn't get those, and I'll be able to comment on those in detail when we get in a debriefing session.
Oh, Roger. Did you observe any small craters with conspicuously blocky rims? Over.
Well, aside from the real big one that we went over, I guess there were none in our area. I took a stroll back after putting up the PSEP, and while Buzz was starting to unpack the documented sample, took a stroll back to a crater behind us that was maybe 70 or 80 feet in diameter and 15 or 20 feet deep, and took some pictures of it. It had rocks in the bottom of pretty good size, considerably bigger than any that were out on the surface, but there was no, we apparently at 15 feet or so had not got below the regolith. We were essentially showing no bedrock, at least in the walls of the crater, at that depth. Over.
Roger, we copy. Okay, thank you, Neil. That about wraps up the questions we have on hand for now.
Okay.
My compliments to the chef. The food's outstanding. This cream of chicken soup, I give at least 3 spoons.
Okay, cream of chicken, 3 spoons. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead.
11, we concur that having verb 16, noun 20 up on the disky may well have had some effect in your PTC initiation. It looks like this would let the computer work with a knowledge of the axial CDU angles. What we'd like you to do is do a CDU 0, which is verb 40, noun 20, enter, and then start the PTC procedure again at step 2 with loading verb 6, noun 22, desired attitude, and the auto maneuver and all that, over.
Okay, the only thing I don't understand about that is why it took off at the rate it did. What rate should it have taken off at under that theory?
Stand by a minute, Mike. 11 CMP, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
Mike, over here on page 9-7 of your checklist where we're setting up PTC, there's been a note penciled in after wait 20 minutes for rates to damp. Do not monitor verb 16, noun 20. It turns out that the significance of that is that if you are monitoring 16, noun 20, then when you get down here in step 7, the second time you do a verb 24, you've got to reload the noun 01 to make it verb 24, noun 01, enter before you load the three registers, over.
Roger that. I was just questioning the rate at which the maneuver would begin if that were not done.
Roger, we're still working on computing the rate for you. Houston, we'd like you to select react mode on the high gain antenna. Looks like we're about to lose you. Over.
This is Apollo Control at 152 hours, 9 minutes. At this time, the crew is getting the spacecraft set up to reinitiate the passive thermal control. Apollo 11, currently 165,143 nautical miles from the Earth, and traveling at a speed of 4,142 feet per second. The flight plan has relatively few activities scheduled for now through the beginning of the crew sleep period tonight. We do have a television transmission scheduled. I believe the time on that is a little after 8 p.m. Central Daylight Time. And we show the sleep period to begin at about 160 hours ground elapsed time, or a little less than 8 hours from now. We'll continue to stand by for any conversation with the crew. It has been relatively quiet for a good part of today. And we'll stand by for a call from the Capcom or from the spacecraft down to the ground. Thank you.
Apollo 11, Apollo 11. This is Houston broadcasting in the blind. If you read us, attempt to acquire on Omni antennas. Attempt to acquire us on Omni antennas if you read. This is Houston out. Apollo 11, Apollo 11. This is Houston broadcasting in the blind. If you read, attempt acquisition on an Omni antenna. Attempt acquisition using an Omni antenna. Over. Apollo 11, Apollo 11. This is Houston broadcasting in the blind. If you read, attempt contact using Omni antennas. Using an Omni antenna. This is Houston out.
This is Apollo Control at 152 hours, 29 minutes. In the process of reestablishing the passive thermal control with the spacecraft in a slow rotation, we have apparently lost high gain lock-on. We expect that the crew will reacquire lock with the antenna once the passive thermal control is reestablished. At the present time, Apollo 11 is 164,320 nautical miles from the Earth, and the velocity is up now to 4,156 feet per second. We'll continue to stand by here for reacquisition of the spacecraft for reestablishment of high gain lock-on.
Thank you.
Apollo 11, Apollo 11, this is Houston, broadcasting in the blind. If you read us, attempt acquisition using an Omni antenna. Attempt acquisition using an Omni antenna. This is Houston out. Thank you. Goldstone. Apollo 11, this is Houston. How do you read? Over.
Right, clear, Bruce. Tell me.
Roger. What antenna are you using?
How do you read? Over.
Roger, loud and clear on the high gain.
So what's new?
Oh, we were wondering what was new with you up there.
Oh, very quiet. We're letting the thruster firing damp down. When they get good enough, let us know and we'll start this PTC.
Roger. Roger, we'll give you a call when your rates have damped down sufficiently, and we're unable at the present time to predict what rate you should have seen At your last attempt to initiate PTC, we saw about 2.5 degrees per second, over.
Yeah, I believe that. Bud thinks we should have a PTC program built into the computer. He could very well be right.